beyond 3D.
Saturday evening, in and around the peninsula, welcome to this week's edition of Beyond 3D. Matt Adams and Clint Hamill here with you. Hopefully, everyone enjoyed this past week. It is getting towards springtime here in the peninsula, in Melbourne, in Victoria, Australia, and the weather is starting to warm up. So for us, it has been a lovely week weather-wise. We can get out, we can get some of that sunshine into the skin, into the blood, into the body, and start to enjoy the warmer weather. For all you guys in the Northern Hemisphere, good luck coming into the fall and the winter time. Hopefully you will weather it well. The weather has not been very good up that way, but hey, it's going to get better. Hopefully it will get better and better and better for you. Streaming live over the internet at www.rppfm.com.au/stream, or that big green button on the right-hand side of the website to listen to the show live on RPP over the internet. This week, we're going to do something a little bit different. We're going to do a meditation session. The reason being, as you well know, if you've listened to this show, there has been a lot of interesting things going on in the past weeks, months, and years. We are spiritually evolving. We are, as a planet, evolving to the point where we are now out loud talking about going to the stars, going out into space, setting up off-world bases and stations. But with that comes some very, very dark and negative energy. And that can be something that can really bring people down. Very viscous, very thick, very hard to fathom most days. So what we're going to do is we're going to give ourselves some techniques that will help us on a daily basis get through that, get around that, accept it head on at sometimes, and recognize the fact that it is what has been called by many sages, saints, and gurus a play of consciousness. Not that big of a deal. You don't have to worry about it too much, but at the same time, you have to be aware. And so being that we have to be aware, what we are going to do is make sure that all of the things that are going on in our lives can be controlled. Can be controlled from a point of view of loving ourselves, loving others, helping ourselves, helping others. Very, very important. So what you'll hear tonight is myself giving you about a 10-minute meditation instruction on a meditation that I tend to do on a daily basis and how you can take that into your lives and work with it. After that, we will hear from one of my teachers, Grandmaster, Pranic Grandmaster, Choa Kok SUI of the Philippines, doing OM a certain number of times, and we will explain why it was done a certain number of times as well. Hopefully, you will enjoy this show this evening. It's for our own spiritual benefit, it's for our own spiritual evolution, and it is for us to recognize the fact that just because there's a lot of negativities going on out there doesn't mean that we have to take them in, take them on, and run with them all of the time. As a matter of fact, we can reject them and go for higher energy forms that will truly help us. Sit back, relax, and enjoy. Meditation. Many people have been looking for a meditation practice that they could use, something that would allow them to calm themselves, recognize that there's more out there than they can possibly imagine. So there are many different forms, many different schools, too many to count. But what some people have done is they have spent decades traveling around the planet trying to find different meditation techniques. And what tends to happen with these people, with some of them, is the fact that after a while, meditation can become instantaneous. Meditation does not have to be something that takes you an hour to do in the morning and an hour to do in the evening. Meditation can be instantaneous. How? How can it be instantaneous? How can you get the benefit of 2 hours of meditation in, let's say, 1 minute? takes time, takes effort, takes practice. And you can't start by just meditating for 1 minute. The goal is to get it to the point where you can activate what needs to be activated and get into that state within 1 minute, if not sooner. Let's give you a meditation that will help you in a couple of different ways. The first way is it is not just sitting there esoterically thinking or concentrating on your navel. It's guided. But it's guided in a different way. There are steps. Step one, sit in a comfortable position. Step two, while seated in this comfortable position, take out your phone. Step three, bring up the compass on your phone, or if you have a physical compass, bring that up as well. Step four, calibrate the compass and point it to between 340 and 345 degrees north-northwest. Step five, follow those simple instructions and don't ask why. You're seated, you're facing a certain direction. What do you do then? You are going to breathe in deeply and exhale long 9 times. What's the cadence? What's the pace? Your own. Breathe in deep. Exhale long 9 times. That's to relax you, to center you. After that, what are you going to do? What are you going to concentrate on? Well, fact. In your physical frame, which has other frames around it, energy bodies around it, you have three permanent seeds. One is located at the diaphragm area near your solar plexus. Another one is located within the heart, your physical heart. The third is located in the brain, in the center of the brain, where the pineal gland would be located. It's also called the blue pearl. We're going to activate the seeds in order. We're going to start at the diaphragm, the solar plexus. We are going to move up to the heart, and then we're going to center it in the brain. So when you're relaxed, you're going to breathe in, and you're going to concentrate on the solar plexus. You're going to breathe out. You're going to think of sending energy to the solar plexus and having it expand. Then you're going to become aware of the solar plexus and see if you can feel the energy pulsating there. What you're then going to do is you're going to move up to your heart center. And you're going to take a deep breath in with the intent of activating the heart center. And you're going to take a deep breath, you're going to take a deep exhale out. And you're going to think of that center expanding and feel the energy of it. A neat trick that you can use to help the heart really respond is to give it food. What kind of food? Loving thoughts, happy thoughts. Think of the heart as your friend. And what you want to do is share something that was fantastic that happened during the day. Feed it. What you're then going to do is you're going to take the energy from the solar plexus and from the heart. And you are just going to imagine it rising through the throat area, tongue, tip of the tongue area. And you're going to put that energy right in between the eyebrows, the ajna chakra, the so-called third eye. It's the lower third eye. And then you're going to take a nice deep breath in, breathe out, and let that energy from the solar plexus and the heart settle there in between the eyebrows. Then what you're going to do is you're going to take that energy and you're going to think of the pineal gland. And the pineal gland, and you're going to draw a line from between the eyebrows going to the back of your head. And from the tips of the top of the ears going through the head. Almost like you have an arrow going through your head. Where those points intersect is where you will find the pineal gland, and where you will find the third permanent seed. And your intent is to move that energy into that seed and to feel, to wait, to listen, to wait for that activation to happen. You will feel it. The direction you're facing in will help you feel that energy. You're doing this with intent. At first, it'll take more than a minute. It can take up to 15 minutes. But as you do this daily, and you get used to activating the solar plexus, used to activating the heart, used to bringing the energies up into the third eye, and then into the pineal gland and the brain, you will become quicker and quicker. The activations will happen faster. And you will get to that point where it will literally take you a minute or less to feel what it is like when the pineal gland is awake, alive, activated. What will also happen is it will naturally start to decalcify. It's like chipping away. It's been covered up. And what you're doing is sending energy that will peel all the so-called dead skin away, and you'll be able to move forward. Every evening, not in the morning, every evening, try this activation. Persevere. Continue with it. If you can do it for 7 days, it will become habitual. It will be easy. And the more you do it, the less time it will take. And one day you will be able to sit down, take in a deep breath, activate, 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 done. Seconds. That's the goal.
Beyond, beyond, beyond.
Oh. 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 Oh.
Chanting the mantra Om 108 times. 108 as a number has long been considered sacred in Hinduism, which is probably the oldest religion on this planet we know as Earth. Malas, rajakshas, or prayer beads come as a string of 108 beads. A mala is used for counting as you repeat the mantra, similar to the Catholic rosary. Mathematicians of Vedic culture viewed 108 as a number of wholeness of existence. This number also connects the sun, moon, and the earth. The average distance of the sun and the moon to earth is 108 times their respective diameters. According to yogic tradition, there are 108 sacred sites throughout India. And there are also 108 Upanishads, sacred texts, the ancient texts. There are 108 sacred places of the body, so that number 108 is not an arbitrary thing. There's always a reason. You will find that when you start to practice meditation regularly, that life will become clearer. And that, from a beyond 3D standpoint, is something that needs to happen. Why? Lately, here in Australia, the government has belittled and berated things that they consider to be unproven. Natural therapies, yoga, Reiki, Bowen therapy, etc. Meditation falls into that category. But our guys don't fall for that. We're not going to be duped into believing that. These technologies, these methodologies are ancient, and they work. They can't be controlled necessarily by government and their buddies in the health industry and the insurance industry. Those industries, all three of them, rely on us lasting a certain amount of years. Insurance actuaries can tell you, probably within within 3 months or so, just how long you'll be here on Earth. They wouldn't want you doing things that can both prolong and enhance your life because that can cost them money. Based on that alone, meditate. Meditate, and then meditate some more.
Thank you.
That's it for this week. What we want you guys to do is to set up a meditation practice to help yourself both physically and spiritually. And also listen to your inner voice. It's usually behind the right ear, back of the head. Your regular thoughts are more frontal near the left side front of the forehead area. So learn to recognize the difference between the two and learn to listen to that inner soul force that connects with all of us. We will catch you next week for another edition of Beyond 3D. Till then, meditate.
Just because you haven't experienced it, doesn't mean it doesn't exist.